leads to the second major fathering decision that men and women, when they're both successful, they are two career men and women, and they talk about their independence and their liberation. And then one day you go over to their house, and you sit down and they say, guess what? I'm pregnant, she says. And then we listen to her, and we listen to him, and we find that that evening we're listening more to her dilemmas about whether to be full-time involved with the children, whether to be full-time involved with the workplace, or whether to be involved with some combination of children in the workplace. So she's generating three options for her life. And the man is sitting there figuring out what the three options is best for the woman. Without any articulation, we're seeing the future father say to himself, oh yeah, I have also three options. Option one is work full-time. Option two is work full-time. And option three is work full-time, or work two jobs, or work overtime. And so we introduce ourselves to fatherhood by supporting, through in a liberated way, we think, our wives to tailor their lives according to their values and their internal belief as to how a child should be taken care of if they're married to a successful man. And our first step of fatherhood is to intensify our commitment, not to our children, but to the workplace. Therefore, taking ourselves away from love in order to support those we love. And we therefore create the first tragedy of fatherhood, that is, we begin to define fatherhood as moving ourselves away from those we love in order to support those we love. And that becomes the beginning of the male tragedy, and it becomes the beginning of our message to our boys, our sons, as to how they should handle fatherhood. And therefore, if a divorce comes about because the man is handling the situation, if the man is handling the economic situation well, it seems like he's contributed well to the family's what I call financial womb, W-O-M-B. It's his contribution to nurturance. But if he's doing that well, he's a distant image to his son. And if he's doing that poorly, he's a close image to his son. He has more time around the home, but he's not an image that's respected in the community. So the son loses either way. He loses if his father's doing well, but he doesn't, because he doesn't know his dad. He loses if his father is doing not well economically, because he knows a dad that isn't as respected as the other dad. And that's a message that the men's center needs to correct, that we need to send out to men and to women. And I believe that probably the first decision that we need to change, if we are, for those of us in the men's center that are able to look out to the world outside of themselves and be effective in that world as well, is recognizing that the biggest single change that occurred for women in this world, in this century, was the change